Okay, so welcome back, and now we're going to introduce properties of integrals, or indefinite integrals, okay? So now, what this is saying is that we can apply certain properties to integrals. So here it says, properties of says let f and g be antiderivatives of f and g, okay? Respectively. So let capital F and capital G be antiderivatives of F and G respectively, and let K be any real number. Then these properties hold. So sum and difference properties. The integral of the sum or difference of two functions is equal to the sum and difference of their individual antiderivatives plus C. Okay? In other words, you can bring the integral inside across addition and subtraction. Okay? So in other words, the integral of the sum or difference is the same as the sum of the integral, the sum or difference of the integrals. Okay? We'll get to more details of that later, but for right now, just realize that that's what's going on. And then the constant multiple is that we can pull the constant out because the constant has nothing to do with x. And remember, we're integrating the function with respect over x, right? That's the integrating variable, or the variable of integration. Since it's a constant, we can pull it out. So that's why it becomes k times the integral of this, which gives us this, plus c, okay? So these are the problems. Now I'm saying this, but again, later on, we're gonna show you why. Okay, so we'll get more formal, okay? And that's it, those are the properties that we're going to use to now find the antiderivative for more complicated functions, okay? Have a great day.